the last committee is that the performance appraisals has the compliance and the completion has been increased to 96%. Again, not 100%. There may be an issue that's not all staff that are working at all times, so we probably need to actually have a look at that to make sure the target is an accurate target. In terms of the children and young people department staff, again, this is linked to the issue with the Audit inspection and the action plan that they're actually working through there. They have 59% of all their appraisals completed, and they actually have a new deadline or an extended deadline of the 31st of March. Again, it's the same process. We focus on HR business partners. They are actually coming to the department and the teams. It has been based on our strategic leadership team. There is a better option to make sure that the appraisals are completed.
Congratulations for achieving that. It's a real well done around that. management is still a really weak area, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And I think that is something that I'm sure we'd be concerned about. And I'm sure, well, I'd like to think that the organisation would be concerned about and putting in place strategies to try and get better if we can.
And I think it would be very remiss of us as a present committee not to raise that issue.
Yeah, Angela.
Yeah, I was just going to ask about, is this kind of our substantive staff that we're talking about in joining people's departments? What about the agency workers? Because that is a, isn't it a proportion, significant proportion in children's services? So I wasn't sure whether the 59% of all CYPD staff was our substantive staff, or
I think it's on the payroll of the I'm assuming these are payrolls.
That's not to say we shouldn't be doing performance management with agencies. That's what I
said. Yeah, I kept having discussions that might involve the improvement, or I would say this issue was raised, I've been pretty aware of it since November and December. Probably off the top of my head, when I say 160 people involved, about 40 would be agency workers. So, as I would say, they're subject to the same rigorous quarterly reviews, appraisals, management tools to make sure that they're doing the job that the organisation has had to bring them in to pay them for.
It's a fair question.
Planning. Our main on-site work will commence in February.
with an intention of bringing our audit plan for 2017-18 to the March audit committee, so that our large evaluation of key risks, both for the opinion audit and for the value for money conclusion that we undertake. I think we're going to say great deal more, as I said, the articles are for you to approve, so hopefully of varying degrees of interest. I'll take any questions, should there be any, Chair?
Questions?
That's unusual. Thank you very much.
This takes us on to item 9. Thank you, Chair. Members, this is the final report of the evening and of course the chair on the
table. You might go
over. It contains two pieces of pertinent information. One is that in the last quarter there's only been one application to the magistrates for permission for COVID direct surveillance. The other is that there has been prosecution based on previous authorisations. Those details are before you. As ever, we are the next biggest game in town after the CPS. We do various things. Our relationship with the Information Commission has where the governance has changed throughout the years. And is now extremely tight of control, which is presumably why these reports come to you.
Questions?
Just a walk.
The authorisations cancelled in December. So was that cancelled by us or was that cancelled by whoever, the magistrate?
I am presuming, Chair, that it was cancelled by us. Authorisations have a limited time period. They come to an end naturally in any event. But also, obviously, if we consider something that is no longer required,
further questions? In that case, thank you everybody for the attendance. Okay, there's also a few shout-out. Strictly speaking, there's an item change, but there's not